In Western Canada today, pea and lentil crops are a conspicuous part of the landscape. They are a popular rotation crop for cereal and canola acres, and their value is enhanced by their ability to fix atmospheric nitrogen. This means the soil doesn't have to be supplemented with synthetic nitrogen from fossil fuels, so it makes for a very sustainable crop. Significantly, from an economic perspective, about 55% of all peas and 50% of lentils grown are exported. BASF is a global leader in the production of self-adhering peat and solid core granule inoculants designed to optimize these pea and lentil crops. The self-adhering peat and solid core products are produced in Canada and serve both the Canadian and global markets. Let's see how they're made and how their quality is assured. Beginning with samples from the mother inoculant culture, a starter culture is established and grown overnight until it reaches a specific cell number, and then that will be the starter culture for the much larger fermenter. The first quality control step is then taken, where the technician ensures that the right strain is being used and that there is no contamination. The starter culture is put into a large-scale fermenter that increases the starter culture to a volume large enough to meet the commercial production needs. The fermenting vessels come in different sizes, allowing the process to be scaled as needed. The process is continually monitored to ensure that production parameters are met. The base peat for the inoculants is specially sourced from a specific bog that meets strict quality and composition criteria. Since it is naturally sourced, it contains bacteria and fungi that exist in the natural environment, so it's ground to meet particle size standards, packaged up and shipped out for irradiation-based sterilization. In the injection room, the bags of sterilized peat are exposed to ultraviolet light as they move into the injection area. This light's strength and duration makes certain that any biological contamination on the surface of the bag, such as bacteria or fungi, will be destroyed. When the fermenting cultures are ready, they'll be injected into the peat. Everything in this workspace is sterilized. The process is automated to ensure that a specific number of cells goes into each bag and waste is minimized. After injection, the bags go through a tumbler to spread the injected culture throughout the peat and ensure that a consistent product is produced. This step ensures that the inoculated peat in the corners of the bags is identical to the peat in the middle. The bags are manually flattened so that the product cures evenly. At the same time, they're checking to make sure there are no holes in the packaging. The bags are now moved to a climate-controlled curing room, where they will be held for several weeks to grow to the required cell number necessary for efficient inoculation. It's important to remember that these are living products, a small number of cells that have been provided with all the nutrients they need to survive and grow. The final product is a result of this growth, so this step is critical. Consequently, a great deal of care is taken to monitor the curing room to ensure optimal conditions are maintained at all times. Random bags of self-adhering peat are selected throughout the curing process. A sample is weighed out and a series of tests including cell count and moisture are conducted to make sure the product meets all quality standards prior to being approved for final sale. When curing is complete, some of the self-adhering peat gets an overbag with all the label information on it, and it is distributed commercially. However, some of those bags are saved and used in the production of solid core granule. Solid core granule production requires a series of highly controlled processes and equipment to be linked together in the manufacturing process. This control panel is the nerve center for the operation. It all starts with a special clay particle, which is shipped to BASF in large totes from a third-party supplier. The clay is transferred by a conveyor to the top mixer to begin the process of making solid core granules. Water, nutrients, and other liquid components are added to the clay as part of the manufacturing process and to support the bacteria that will be living in the granules. Once the granules begin to form in the top mixer and have reached the required size and shape, self-adhering peat containing the rhizobia from the previous process is added. This is one of the most critical steps, as this is where the bacteria are introduced into the solid core product. After a period of mixing and tumbling, the product is now transferred to the bottom mixer, where it continues to form the solid core granule. Once a predetermined size and shape is met, a final coating material is added to seal the solid core granule and protect it from crumbling. Once this is complete, the product is transferred to a rotary compactor, where the solid core granules are transformed into product ready to be used by the grower. As the product leaves the rotary compactor, a visual inspection is made and large clumps are either broken up or completely removed from the mix. The product then moves from the rotary compactor to a mechanical screener that removes the large particles that do not meet the strict size criteria. A sample is taken from the stream coming out of the screener and is tested to ensure that moisture levels are within BASF's strict specifications. If the product meets the moisture requirements, a sample is then taken to the lab where a screen test takes place. This test is conducted to ensure that the product contains the correct proportion of intact solid core granules, as well as contains only a certain level of fine particles. The product passes this quality step if there are less than 1% fines. This step is critical as it ensures that the product flows properly through application equipment. If it passes the test, the product can then be put into bags. Careful, accurate handling is a crucial aspect of quality control. An automatic bagger accurately fills the bags, then a robotic palletizer stacks them uniformly, and a shrink wrapping station stabilizes the pallet to take the product from manufacture to ready to ship. Before shipping, the product is held on the floor where it continues to grow and cure. Samples are tested for sufficient cell count before being released for distribution. Product is not released for commercial sale until all moisture, particle size, and cell number criteria are met. When loading it onto the truck, the product is restricted to a single pallet height. Double stacking of pallets negatively impacts the product quality from both an efficacy and usability perspective. All product being shipped from BASF to distributors is single stacked. BASF inoculants are living organisms, and as such, they have a finite shelf life. The products are produced just in time for the growing season to ensure maximum efficacy. Delivering them in time for a grower to use in the spring requires extensive forecasting, scheduling, and logistics planning. Understanding the production process for these inoculants is an important step that aids in recognizing the extensive quality control and quality assurance processes involved in growing and harvesting these organisms. Pulses are an incredibly important and valuable crop for Canadian farmers. As an industry leader with a broad portfolio of fungicides, insecticides, herbicides, and seed treatments, BASF is committed to helping pulse growers increase the yields and the quality of their crops in a sustainable manner. Inoculants are a vital part of that commitment. To ensure that all growers' inoculant demands are met, BASF has recently expanded their production facility in an attempt to meet the growing demand for these products.